Hello friends, beginning of the new month and we are more close to next UGC exam. I'm Poonam Dua from MN Education Academy of Literature. Aim of our academy is to provide maximum useful literary information to all the exam aspirants, and today I'm here with information on titles and subtitles of famous literary work useful for net set examinations. Along with title and subtitles, I'll also give a brief information about that text too, and as usual there is a quiz link in description box too. Go for that after doing a thorough study of this video and judge your score, your knowledge yourself. Here you go, please share and subscribe my channel too. The first text that we are covering today is Frankenstein or the Modern Prometheus, which was published in January 1818. Frankenstein or the Modern Prometheus is a novel written by English author Mary Shelley, which tells the story of Victor Frankenstein, Dr. Victor Frankenstein, a young scientist who creates a hideous creature in an unorthodox scientific experiment. Many people mistakenly think that Frankenstein refers to the monster, but the monster has never been given the name. Dr. Victor Frankenstein, who creates the monster, is the modern Prometheus. This reference to Prometheus came from Greek mythology. Prometheus created humans out of water and clay, and he angered God Zeus by stealing fire from the gods and giving it to mortals. Prometheus was one of the titans and the brother of Atlas, God Atlas. The next one, Slaughterhouse 5 or The Children's Crusade, A Duty Dance with Death. Such a big subtitle. It was published in 31st March 1969 and is a science fiction which infuses anti-war, and it is a novel by Kurt Vonnegut about World War II experience of a character, Billy Pilgrim. This novel introduces us to Billy Pilgrim, a man who becomes unstuck in time after he is abducted by aliens from the planet called Trelfemedore. The next one, Oliver Twist or The Parish Boy's Progress, which is the subtitle. Oliver Twist or The Parish Boy's Progress is Charles Dickens' second novel and was first published as a serial from 1837 to 39. The story centers upon an orphan, Oliver Twist, who was born in a workhouse and was further sold into a training with an undertaker. The next one, Middlemarch, and the subtitle, A Study of Provincial Life. It was first published in 8 installments in 1871 to 1872. Middlemarch was written by Mary Ann Evans using the pen name George Eliot. As the name implies, the name of the novel implies, the novel is about the lives of a number of people who live in the provincial town of Middlemarch. It is a very complex novel which comprises many characters and a number of themes. The novel is set in fictitious Midlands town of Middlemarch during 1829 to 32 and follows several distinct, interesting, intersecting stories with a large cast of characters. The next one, Twelfth Night or What You Will. What You Will is the subtitle. This was a play by William Shakespeare and it was first performed on 2nd February 1602. It is one of the only two Shakespeare plays to have a subtitle. The other is Henry VIII or All is True. Some Shakespeare scholars suggest he was mocking the whole subtitle craze by giving Twelfth Night a completely useless subtitle that added absolutely no extra information about the play. Twelfth Night or What You Will is a comedy by William Shakespeare, believed to have been written around 1601 or 1602 as a Twelfth Night's entertainment for the close of the Christmas season. The play centers on the twins Viola and Sebastian, who are separated in a shipwreck. The next one is a controversial one, Tess of the D'Urbervilles, A Pure Woman Faithfully Presented. This is a novel by Thomas Hardy, which was originally published in 1891. It was subtitled A Pure Woman Faithfully Presented because the writer felt that its heroine was a virtuous victim of the so-called narrow-minded Victorian moral codes, and now it is considered to be Hardy's masterpiece, masterwork. It departed from conventional Victorian fictions in its focus on the rural lower class and in its open treatment of sexuality and religion, which was a very big issue in that era. The next one, Lorna Doone, A Romance of Exmoor, which was published in 1869. Lorna Doone, A Romance of Exmoor, is a novel by English author Richard Doddridge Blackmore, published in 1869, as I told. It is a romance based on group of historical characters and set in late 17th century in Devon and Somerset, particularly around the East Lynne Valley area of Exmoor. The next one, famous amongst children, Peter Pan or the Boy Who Would Not Grow Up. Peter Pan or the Boy Who Would Not Grow Up, or Peter and Wendy, is J.M. Barrie's most famous work in the form of a 1904 play and a 1911 novel. A play in which Peter brings Wendy and her brother to Neverland, where he has a showdown with his nemesis, with his enemy, Captain Hook. Barrie adopted this play as a novel with numerous variations, and other adaptations have also been produced in various media over the years. The next one, Jane Eyre, which most of you must be acquainted with being a literature student. Jane Eyre, An Autobiography, which is the subtitle. Jane Eyre, originally published as Jane Eyre, An Autobiography, is a novel by English writer Charlotte Bronte, published under the pen name Currer Bell on 16th October 1847 by Smith, Elder and Company of Production. The central character in this Victorian novel is the heroine, narrator and the title character. When it was first published, the novel was subtitled An Autobiography, and Currer Bell was credited as being the editor rather than the author. Charlotte Bronte used the pseudonym Currer Bell when publishing her first two novels, Jane Eyre and Shirley. Jane Eyre was written in the first person narrative, that is, Jane herself tells the story. The next one is Lady Windermere's Fan, A Play About a Good Woman. This is a play by playwright Oscar Wilde, and it is a four-act comedy, first performed on Saturday, 20th February 1892. The story tells us about Lady Windermere, who suspects that her husband is having an affair with another woman. There is some literary debate concerning which character is Good Woman, referred to the subtitle. Some say it is Lady Windermere and others that it is Mrs. Evelyn. Of more importance, however, is Wilde's underlying message that Victorian society was hypocritical in demanding that women must be good, must be chaste, must be pure, while men may not. Men could keep mistresses or have affairs with little damage to their reputation. However, if a woman did likewise, she was a social outcast. In Act 1, for example, the Duchess of Berwick says, "Before the honeymoon was over, I caught him winking at my maid, a most pretty, respectable girl. I dismissed her at once without a character." The next one is Madame Bovary, novel by Gustave Flaubert, who is a French writer. Madame Bovary, or Mors de Provence, which is the subtitle, is the debut novel of French writer Gustave Flaubert, published in 1856. The titular character, Madame Bovary, lives beyond her means in order to escape the staleness and emptiness of the provincial life. Madame Bovary tells the story of Emma, a peasant who marries an older doctor, Charles Bovary, to escape the dullness of rural life. Emma swiftly grows disillusioned with both her husband and their provincial ways, especially after she attends a ball thrown by one of her husband's aristocratic patients. The next one is The Hobbit or There Are Back, a again. The Hobbit or There Are Back Again is a children's fantasy novel by English author J.R.R. Tolkien and was published on 21 September 1937 to wide critical acclaim, being nominated for the Carnegie Medal and awarded a prize for the New York Herald Tribune for Best Juvenile. Bilbo Baggins lives in a peaceful hole under the hill where he is respected and rather rich pillar of the Hobbit community. Hobbits, by the way, are small people with furry toes and big bellies. They like beer and jokes and generally are happy. They believe in hanging out and not making any kind of trouble to anyone. But even though Bilbo has spent his whole life living contently, living peacefully under the hill, an adventure comes to his doorstep. The next one, Silas Marner, the Weaver of Raveloe. Silas Marner, the Weaver of Raveloe, is the third novel by George Eliot, which was published in 1861. It is a simple tale of a linen weaver, and it is notable for its strong realism and sophisticated treatment of varieties of issues ranging from religion to industrialization to community. The next one, Uncle Tom's Cabin, published in 1852. This is a novel by Beecher Stowe. Uncle Tom's Cabin, Life Among the Lowly, was published in 1852. This is an anti-slavery novel. This novel broke all sales record of that time by selling 500,000 copies by 1857. After its publication, Harriet Beecher Stowe traveled to America and Europe speaking out against slavery. When she met President Abraham Lincoln in 1862, he allegedly greeted her by saying, "So, you are the little woman who wrote the book that created this great war." By the great war, he meant Civil War. The next one, Black Beauty, the Autobiography of a Horse. It was published on 24th November 1877, novel by Anna Sewell. Black Beauty is an 1877 novel by English author Anna Sewell, and it was composed in the last years of her life, during which she remained in her house most of the time. The novel became an immediate bestseller, with Sewell dying just 5 months after its publication, but having lived long enough to see her only novel become a success. With 50 million copies sold, Black Beauty is one of the best-selling books of all time. A Christmas Carol in Prose, being a ghost story of Christmas. A Christmas Carol in Prose, being a ghost story of Christmas by Charles Dickens, was published on 19 December 1843. This recounts the story of Ebenezer Scrooge, an elderly miser who is visited by the ghost of his former business partner Jacob Marley and the spirits of Christmas past, present and yet to come future. After their visits, Scrooge is transformed into a kinder, gentler man. Okay, the next one is an interesting one, The Wreck of the Titan or Futility. This is a novel by Morgan Robertson, published in 1898. The Wreck of the Titan or Futility is an 1898 novella written by Morgan Robertson, and the story features the fictional ocean liner ship Titan, which sinks in the North Atlantic after striking an iceberg. And its sinking have been noted to be very similar to the real-life passenger ship named Titanic, which sank just 14 years later. There are too many similarities to be found in Titan and Titanic. The similarities between the Titan and Titanic go far beyond the name and an iceberg. The length of the Titan was 800 feet, the Titanic 882. The speed at which Titan cruised into the iceberg was 25 knots, the Titanic was 22.5. The Titan held 2,500 passengers. The Titanic held 2,200, almost similar number, though both had a capacity of 3,000. After the Titanic tragedy, Robertson was even accused of being clairvoyant. Clairvoyant is a person who claims to have supernatural ability to perceive events in the future or beyond normal sensory level sensory contact. Due to the insane similarities between his work and real life, he was considered to be a clairvoyant. After all, the likelihood of someone writing a book so similar to tragedy that had not even taken place, yet it seems to be almost impossible. The next one, Clarissa, published in 1748. Clarissa or The History of a Young Lady is an epistolary novel by English writer Samuel Richardson, published in 1748. It tells the tragic story of a young woman, Clarissa Harlowe, whose quest for virtue is continually thwarted by her family. The next one, Vanity Fair, a novel without a hero. This is the subtitle. Vanity Fair, a novel without a hero, is a novel by English author William Makepeace Thackeray, first published in 1847-48, follows the lives of Becky Sharp and Emmy Seedley amid their friends and families during and after Napoleon Wars. The novel is now considered a classic and has transpired into several film adaptations. In 2003, Vanity Fair was listed at number 122 on the BBC's The Big Red Poll of UK's Best Loved Books. The next one, Roots, The Saga of an American Family. It is a novel by Alex Haley, published on 17 August 1976. It tells the story of Kunta Kinte, an 18th century African captured as an adolescent, sold into slavery in Africa, transported to North America, following his life and lives of his descendants in the United States down to Haley. The next one is Moby Dick or The Whale. Moby Dick or The Whale was published on 18 October 1851 and it is a novel by Herman Melville. The novel is an epic tale of the voyage of whaling ship the Pequod and its captain Ahab, who relentlessly pursues the great sperm whale, the title character, during a journey around the world. The narrator of the novel is Ishmael, a sailor on the Pequod, who undertakes the journey out of his affection for the sea. Moby Dick, the giant white sperm whale that on the ship's previous voyage bit off Ahab's leg at the knee. Please go to the quiz through the link given in the description box. This way you will be able to judge your knowledge. Best of luck for your exams. Please subscribe to our channel to gain more knowledge about English literature and contact to join our face-to-face classes. Thanks a lot for watching.